What's up guys, Zach Carly here, and today I'm back with another woodworking video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make my pallet planter. This is one I made a year ago. We painted it obviously, and as you can see it stood the test of time. It's all in one piece, we've had no problems with it. You can put plant pots in them, or in this one we've got like a membrane and just put soil in it. And yeah, it's a really, really simple design. You don't need many tools, all you need is a saw, some screws, a drill and glue if you want, but I'm not going to use glue. Actually I think I will use a bit of glue in my one this time. But yeah, this is the structure of it. As you can see, there's just uprights on each corner with some screws going in to the other piece, and that's on every corner, and then there's some across bits between each corner bit, and then underneath there's just a little bit. You can't see it, but I will show you how it's made when I make my new one, and that's just to hold whatever in the bottom of it. So yeah, this is what yours could look like, and hopefully I can make one that looks just as good this time around. So let's get to the workshop. Right guys, so as I was saying, you are actually going to need some screws, preferably 35mm, they're pretty good for going through two bits of pallet, depending on the size of the pallet obviously, but 35s I think are generally quite good. You'll need a saw, any type of saw will do, jigsaw, handsaw, chop saw. I'm going to use my chop saw just because I have the luxury of using one, but you can quite as easily just use one of these. So yeah, you need one of those. Glue preferably for the corners, not so much for the bits going across, but just the corner bits. We've got a group glue and screw them together to make the legs. And also a drill. You do really need a drill. I mean, if you're going to hand pilot it with a hand drill and use a screwdriver, you can do that, but really you need a drill. So what we're going to do is I'll select some timber and I'll get cutting for the legs. Bear in mind, you need to cut your legs high enough to be able to take however many bits of cross pieces you want. You can make this in any size, I'll let you do that, pick what size you want. But yeah, I'm going to figure out how many pieces I need and then I'll get cutting. So my first job was to figure out what wood I had and how it would all pan out, and I figured out that when I had three pieces of wood put together, it would be about 10 inches wide or so. So I cut my legs to 12 inches, which meant there'd be about a 2-inch leg gap at the bottom. And because I'm having three pieces on each side, I basically figured out that I needed 12 pieces to go all the way around. And then after that, I got my leg pieces and glued and screwed them together. Glued them first, put my clamps on, and just put three screws through. Make sure you pilot the screws because obviously it's pallet wood and it will split, and you really don't want that, but you basically got to go and start again. And yeah, like I said earlier, 35mm screws are really good for this. Most pallet wood is pretty similar sized, so yeah, 35mm screws will be safe, but if yours is a bit too thick, or not a bit too thick, a bit thicker, then basically just use longer screws. It's up to you to determine that. So yeah, once I've done that, I stood my two side pieces up on end and screwed together upwards. Make sure you line up all the top pieces and the bottom pieces so it doesn't look a bit odd or anything. Then after that, I got some more pallet wood and just measured out how big I needed the pieces to be to make a bottom pad. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. And then just use four screws to hold that in place. Right guys, so here is the finished plant box. As you can see, I have done it pretty well. I think the colours look really good, and I've chosen bits with the nail heads and stuff, the holes and stuff, just to make it look a bit more funky. And inside you can just see I've put this in to stop pots falling through, or whatever you want to put inside. In the garden, like I showed you earlier, we've got like a membrane stuff with soil in it. And this is the same setup, and it does stop soil falling through if you've got the membrane in. Obviously, if you just put soil in, it's just going to go straight through the hole. But if you've got the membrane, it doesn't sag, it stays in place. And yeah, it looks pretty decent. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this style of video. I hope you enjoyed the voiceover. I hope my camera work was okay. To be honest, you've just been sitting on top of my drill press. So yeah. And yeah, if you've got any more questions, leave them down below. So please like, subscribe and everything else, and peace. You are better, deeper.